Hey guys, look what Nanny Giggles has got me for Christmas. Oh yeah, it's the new Tropico expansion, Waterborne. And I'm just going to jump in straight away and play this new campaign. And we'll talk about the stuff that's in it as we go along. So I'm just going to grab one of my old Dynasties. I'm just going to play it on the default settings, I think. Because it'll just be a little bit quicker to run through. So what are we going to go for? This is going to be like the original campaign. We're going to be jumping between these islands, I'm guessing. So let's start on... Well, which one looks cool? Well, they both look cool. I'm going to play on Costa Maledicio.
Have you heard the legend of the Black Pearl? It is a jewel of indescribable beauty. Mostly because nobody has ever seen it. Some say that the pearl has mystical powers. Others say that it is cursed. No matter. I want it. The legends say that the pearl is resting in the depths of the Caribbean Sea. A bit of luck and a couple of loaded dice won me a governor's title in the region. The resources of the two islands under my command should help me finance the treasure hunt. The Black Pearl will soon be mine.
Oh, hell yeah. Treasure hunt. Oh.
Greetings, my good chum.
I'm Hello, Lord Oxworth.
You have big plans for this backwater island, yet mind that one does not keep invaluable treasures away from His Majesty.
I suggest you start your treasure hunt with a bit of a ruse. Pretend you are exploiting the riches of the sea for the sake of His Majesty. This should allow you to expand without drawing unwanted attention. Oh, right, here we go. Build 3 oyster farms. Now, I know almost nothing about this new expansion, but you know what? We're just going to dive in and we're just going to do it. You know what? Let's pause this for a second. I'm not going to do much pausing in this because I kind of want to whiz through it. Now, what I do know is that all the waterborne stuff is on this new tab, and I really like that. You haven't got to go searching through all the old menus to try and find what you want. So, oyster farms. Now, I do happen to know that oyster farms get planted on these fishing resources, which is very cool. And obviously, this is what they had in mind when they put these fishing resources in. So let's see. We start off with 10,000. So let's crank these up. Oh, and I should have held down the shift key. I've got to get used to playing this again. It's been a little while. Oh, I've missed Tropico, haven't you? Haven't you missed a bit of Tropico? Love it. Right, let's get this going. What's this mission over here?
As you know, His Majesty is fond of setting fire to things. He has decided to build the world's largest bonfire and needs all the wood he can get.
Right, that's one of the old missions. Build a logging camp. Now, you know what? Let's try and boost things up a bit, I think. Right, we're going to do a bit of wood going on. So I'm going to put in... you know what? Let's use the hotkeys. Let's put in a road. That's a bit awkward there. Let's put in a road, kind of sort of up here ish. Probably like about there. And let's just bring it round. You know what? If it'll do it, I might bring it round kind of towards this mine. There we go. Kill two birds with one stone. That hasn't connected, has it? Ugh, wonderful. Right, now let's put in some logging. So that's going to be in the resources and logging camp. And we'll throw in... Ooh, logging's not fantastic around here. This bit's green around here. Let's throw a logging camp in. Let's get it the right way around. Let's try and get into good habits for this series. Not put stuff in the wrong way. And right, so I think we want it probably about there for maximum performance. But we've got some more stuff down in this area, so I'm thinking let's run a road out this way, like kind of sort of along the coast ish kind of sort of thing. So hard to get the roads to run like kind of smoothly along the coast, and that's a it'll come as far as that. Now this is one kind of trick that you can kind of sort of do. When you've got this fog of war, right, you can't place buildings in the fog of war, but you can place them kind of half in, half out. So where can I put a logging camp and kind of make use of this? See, I can put a logging camp like there. If I turn it around that way and get it like right up here. Let's put a logging camp in like around there, I think. Right, let's put in a road connection for it. See, I'm getting into good habits. I'm trying to play a bit better than I did like in the first game play, which was a bit hit and miss here and there. Now, we're going to want some other resources. We've got a bit of corn over there, but I want to get the cash flowing in really quickly. Try and speed this along. So I'm thinking we put in some plantations, and I'm thinking we go for like, we can either do cotton. How's cotton? Oh, cotton's not bad around here, actually. Oh, we could do some cotton. We could do some cotton up here. I'll squeeze a plantation in next to the... Almost. We could cut down on the corn maybe a little bit. You know what? I'm going to do that. You know what? Let's put it in there. And I'm going to hold down the shift key because I'm going to put in... We're going to do some cotton. We're going to do some cotton on this island, I think. So let's pop another one in. Ooh, will these fit in like two across the back? They will. How about that? It's not often that my spacing actually works out. Right, in that case, yeah. Well, let's bang one in there and one in. Oh, it won't quite fit. Will you fit there? No. Oh man. Oh, why won't you fit there? Oh, that's a shame. That's like a big shame. Let's see if we spin it. Oh, yeah, you lose all of this. Oh, that's a shame. That's a shame. But what we can do is we can put it in like that. Right, so we'll do that. So I need a road for that thing. So let's pop a road in for this. Oh, God. I need to get this going ASAP, I think. Because I can't wait. Can't wait for this. I'm going to leave a bit of room next to the palace for a change. Maybe put some buildings in next to it or something. So, like, how about like that? Now, one thing I'm going to do. Now, we've only got, like, 100 inhabitants. So, that's probably going to be okay for what we've put in so far. I'm just wondering if I can squeeze some more plantations in over here. I probably can't. But you know what? We're going to crank it up, right? And there's going to be, hopefully, very little pausing as we go forward. Now,
old chap, have I got a deal for you today? As Crown Representative, I can offer you your very own trading license.
That's very nice of you. Now, what are we going to go for? We can't afford the silver package, so I'm actually going to go for the cheap license from the Dutch. Now, that does mean that we get minus 10 to Crown Relations, but to be honest, don't really care. Alrighty, so people are going to work now. Excellent stuff. Now the question is, do we bump up the budgets on these buildings? I'm thinking we probably do pretty soon, but we need to start exporting some stuff because we've kind of spent all of our cash.
Old chap, now that His Majesty trusts you, he requires you to ensure the well-being of the royal swine.
Wow, cool. His Majesty recently bred a new type of swine, those are pigs, in his royal pigsty, spelt wrong. He personally tends to their needs and plans to start feeding them the most pristine pearls, which you have to provide. Export 5,000 pearls. Right, let's do that then. Cool. We could do with another construction thing. I can't even remember what it's called now. Another construction office. We can't afford one. 1,600 we need. Right. I might just speed this up a little bit then. Come on, go, 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 guys. Go to work. Build. Cut down. Do all the good things. We've got the Teamsters.
His Royal Majesty has instructed me to present you with this letter of commendation.
Excellent.
Your achievements in the name of the Empire.
I'm not going to take the I'm going to take the cash to kind of speed things up a little bit. And let's have a look at our population and see what we've got. So we've got 19 people who are unemployed. So we've still got people who can like do stuff. I'm not going to worry about housing, at least not until I get options, like missions to do housing and
Technological
stuff.
Technological progress is the path to autonomy, Governor.
Build a library.
More scientists.
Yeah, okay. We can build a library. We can do that. If I can remember where the hell it is. It's in education. Library. 5,000 we need. Oh, we need a bit more cash. Need a bit more cash. Come on, ships. Ships, arrive. Sell stuff. Oh, come on, come on, come on. I want to build new cool things. Oh, our plantations are getting built. We've got this one over here that needs to get built as well. Let's start shipping some cotton. Now, cotton and, let's see, cotton and cocoa, they're the most profitable of the plantations. So, like, getting these things in early, and then we can maybe do some, get some wool going as well. It's going
to
be good.
Day. I traded all my money for a magic compass that will show us the way to the Black Pearl. We only have to close our eyes and wish with all our heart.
See, like, very obviously, this is all, like, Pirates of the Caribbean stuff. So, like, the Black Pearl and Captain Joe and Captain Jack and the Magic Compass and all that kind of thing. I'm loving this. I met a really strange pirate, who goes by the name of Captain Joe. After a couple of pints, his tongue loosened and he told me about his Magic Compass that was supposed to lead him to the Black Pearl. He wasted his life trying to find it and he has given up. This is a great chance to dedicate our lives to the same goal. Ah, loving it. And we're actually bringing in a bit of cash, which is very nice. Now, am I going to spend my cash on the library? Now, you know what? I'm going to... Am I going to get more construction in at this point? Probably not.
His Majesty
take this quest.
Wants to exchange wood for sheep. Wood for sheep.
Ah, love this joke. Wood for sheep.
Well, if you
I remember that.
Sheep, then I guess you'll have
Yeah. All right. Right, export logs. Right, I think we want some more logging going on then. Mind you, we've got one over there, we've got one over here, so we've got a couple of logging camps. They should produce a fair old amount of wood. Look at them cutting down the trees. We never looked at this very much when I was going through the original campaign. You actually see them cutting down trees and stuff. We'll try and do more of that. We'll try and do more zooming in and, like, enjoy, because this is a pretty game. There's no question about it. Like, there's lots of stuff going on. The graphics are very nice in this, which I don't think I appreciated enough originally. Right, the Krause just sent us 4,500. We're back into almost positive territory, which is fairly staggering. We've got a ship coming in. How much is that going to bring us in? Oh, look at this. 7,800 or 8,000 already? 9,800. Wow. We're flying, guys. We're absolutely flying. Right, well, what should we do? Let's have a look at our population. We've got 84 employed. We've got 5 unemployed, so we can still do a bit more if we wanted to. I'm going to put in... Am I going to put in a high school, like, really... that's not unlocked until the World War, so we can't do that. So I guess probably library is the next thing. So let's put a library in. Should we put it down by the palace? I don't want to put it, like, in front of the palace, though. I want to put it, like, maybe there. Actually, yeah, let's space that out. We could probably put something else in front of it. Yeah, let's pop that in there. Do I want to put another construction place in? It's kind of what I'm debating at the moment. And do I want to put more plantations in? Really tempted to get more cash going. Should we put another plantation in? And, like, can I get... Oh, man, I can't... Oh, I can there. I need to move that road. All right, well, let's do that then. Let's do a bit of demolishing. Let's demolish that road. And that. And... Oops. No, didn't want to... Oh. Oh, good lord. The demolish tool is... I should have paused it. The demolish tool is a little bit inaccurate. Never mind. What am I doing? I want to put a road in... which I only want to be a little bit longer, and then we'll bring it round to where it was and hook it up. See, I'm getting carried away because I'm too excited. I've got to calm down. I love this. I love this game. Right, so we popped that one in there, and of course I should have held down the bloomin' shift key. Cotton. Yeah, I'm checking that I'm putting the right plantation in. God dear, I'm sure you all remember that from the first series. Right, let's pop another one in there. I wasn't going to put another one in, but I'm really tempted to put another one in. So this is... We could squeeze another one in down here if I moved this road. Which would kind of be no bad thing. I'm going to do that. I'm just enjoying this so much. So I need to take that off there and get that right. There we go. Yeah, I could... Yeah, am I going to do it that way? No, I don't know. I'm so indecisive. Right, roads. Let's put a road, like, straight down here so that we can put the plantation in, like, to there. And then we'll bring it up like, oh, I don't know, like that kind of thing. And let's see if we can get this. Let's see if we can get this plantation in now. We should be able to squeeze it in like pretty much. I want to use as much of this as possible. Although it gets a bit yellow over here, so probably best to put it up that end. Yeah, we don't lose very much. Yeah, let's pop that in there. Cool, excellent. Now, we're not going to have any college-educated workers, so we could invite some foreign workers, but on the basis that we don't really have a huge amount of cash, I'm not going to do that. But I'm seriously thinking about putting in another construction office. Is that a good idea? Is that a good idea? I don't know. Don't know. But if I'm going to put it in, I'm going to put it in over this side. So, I don't know, like maybe... Maybe down here, maybe put some... Actually, might put a dock in there. Ideas. You know what? I'm going to put this guy in. Like, over here, I think. Yeah. There we go. And you know what? We can actually quick build this guy. But, like, what's the point? We don't have a lot of cash at this point, so... Yeah, let it do its thing. Right, let's crank this up a bit. Hopefully we should get a bit more cash coming in. Oh, see, look, another 10,000 coming in. We've learned from the first campaigns and all
His
the challenges.
His Majesty has instructed me to present you with this letter of commendation.
Excellent. We'll take the cash. Because, now, you could take the colonists, right, 10 colonists, or I could take the cash, right? The cash is 5,000. Well,
I'm so excited. I was fishing when Captain Joe's magical compass went crazy. I left my boat to mark the spot and swam back to the shore to tell you.
Bonehead Penultimo. Love you, Penultimo. If we want the Black Pearl, we have to make a large expedition to find it. We could be rich beyond a mortal's imagination. Complete all the tasks to find the Black Pearl. Well, we're going to do that. We should, you know what? We should start getting some research going, shouldn't we? What do we want? I don't really care what upgrade, what... way this is done. But wait, let's take our farm upgrades. Let's just do it in that order. And then we'll queue these up in no particular order. I should probably have done the planks before the trigger and the foreman, but like, whatever. We'll be fine. Right, so we've got research going now. We've got more stuff building, which is sweet. We've got cash coming in, which
it
is super awesome.
I accidentally forgot to drop the anchor when I left my boat. Now the location of the Black Pearl is lost.
Oh, wonderful. If there was only a vault of knowledge where we could trace the myth of the Black Pearl among thousands of old crumbling handwritten pages, build a new library. Well, we've already built one. So, what, I've got to build another one now? Oh, all right then. Let's put in another library. Another library? Really? Am I going to put it there? I should have put these back to back. I should have left a bit of space because they look really good back to back like that. But, I don't know, offset like that, that's not too horrible. Yeah, I could do it like that. Like, what the hell? Could really do with the extra construction workers, to be honest. Get this stuff built a bit quicker. Although, it's building at a reasonable speed. They'll get onto this soon. I'm going to crank that up to a high priority. Get that built quick. Now, I want to get more plantations and stuff going. I want to leave this area over here for, like, industry. That's where we'll do, like, our industrial stuff.
Old chap, His Majesty is positively pipped about you dabbling in suspicious acts. You should concentrate your efforts on feeding his growing royal swine.
Yes, all right. His Majesty finds this disturbing. He hopes you shall not forget the pledge you gave him and will continue to serve your duties without question. Yeah, whatever. We're in it for ourselves, boys. We just got 6,000 from the Crown.
While searching through the crates of colony supplies...
The sickle! We can upgrade our plantations now, which is no bad thing. Now, what's the upgrade for corn? Mechanization. Decreases workers. Oh, yeah, we want that. Gives us two extra workers. This is the corn one. Selective breeding. Effectiveness increase each month. Yeah, we want that as well. Oh, that's already in. Okay. No worries. Right, well, we want this one. And we want this one upgraded as well. Because it's doing this is what makes them really profitable, decreasing the number of workers. And that frees up workers to go and work at other places. So I'm thinking it's probably about time to up the budgets on these.
We need a plan. So while Penultimo was rifling the library, I took my time to read an old book about deep sea diving.
Centuries ago, brilliant scholars used simple underwater bells to hold air while diving to reach long-lost treasures. You have to build a new Catholic mission and appropriate its bell, so we can build a church and then nick the bell. Oh, I love it. Build a new Catholic mission. All right, let's do that. Oh, we've got loads of stuff to do.
Our research team, that is to say...
Mines are unlocked. Okay, thank you. Right, let's get these quests.
Your family's rather rollicking love life has led to an unexpected...
Oh, cool. Well, we need to build a Catholic mission anyway, so we'll get two for the price of one from that. Have a Catholic mission. So we can get three quests done just by building a Catholic mission.
Your Majesty finds your island's backwardness most amusing.
Yeah. Research planks. Right, so we actually want to shift our research around a little bit and get planks done a bit faster. So let's take out the trigger and foreman, right? Then we'll put the... let's have foreman and trigger. And then what we're going to go for? That probably doesn't matter. Right. Boom. Okay, cool. Catholic mission we need, don't we? Yes, we do. Skye, get it built. Right, where am I going to put it? Don't know. Because I haven't got, like, a town as such. And I really want to put it in the town. Welfare and media. There's the Catholic mission. Where are we going to have kind of, like, a sort of a town-ish? I mean, right now, the town is, like, down here. I guess we could move these plantations later and sort of expand this and have this as the town. Yeah, maybe. Maybe. This will kind of fit in here, won't it? Yeah, let's spin that round. Let's have it facing this way. We'll leave a space in between. We can put a tavern in between or something. Let's put that there. We might put some houses down here at some point. Who the hell knows? Who the hell knows? What do we want to do? We're researching planks. That's good. Catholic mission we're building. Good. Let's make that high priority. We've got two lots of those going. How are we doing for workers? We've still got five unemployed, so we can crank things up a bit if we want. I've forgotten. Like, playing on medium is, like, actually pretty easy. I want to up the budgets, don't I? Yeah, I do. Let's up the budgets on cotton. And we're going to up the budget on the corn. And I'm going to up the budget on everything, actually. I'm going to up the budget on the Teamsters, on the construction offices. I'm control-clicking on these to make sure that it applies to all buildings. The library, I'm going to probably just take up to 4 for now. Yeah, that's probably a good idea. The logging camps I want to up. Oh, that's a construction office. Logging camp, there we go. Let's up those to 5. And why am I upping the budgets? Because it makes them more efficient. They make more money. And it makes people... more well off, and they can afford to live in the houses that we haven't built for them, which probably makes them more upset, but that's what it is.
As the air was born, all animals became quiet.
Oh, we've got a new guy. Let's have bow to the infant. Oh, Green Thumb, because I haven't got one of those. Oh, he's pretty impressive. Oh, there's new looks and stuff, aren't there, in this? Oh, achievement unlocked, like that. Right, what new costumes are there? Greaser, businessman. Those were already in, I think. Cold War, dictator, astronaut, Uncle Pedro. Napoleon, like it. Steampunk. Cool. How about... this is the tourist guy, isn't it? Oh, yeah. I think he should look a bit like that for the... Should he have a hat? He should. Fedora, maybe. Yeah, don't like that. Definitely don't like that. All that. Oh, that's kind of interesting. Construction helmet? That's what we want to go with. Oh, hell yeah. Do I want to change anything else? I really don't. That's perfect. Yeah. There we go. Am I going to level him up? Yeah. No. Okay, that's enough of that. Thanks, right.
The revolutionary movement is growing stronger.
Now, when we get these, we're always going to go for the import revolutionaries. Because it brings in educated citizens who are, frankly, awesome. And we need them for, like, our libraries and buildings like that. So, cool. Right, well, we can crank this up again. What else can we do? We're still researching planks.
Yeah,
that's
tested the underwater bell myself, and now my ears hurt. What?
You're such a bonehead, but
I can't hear you.
I love you so much. I want to keep my Tropican comrades from repeating my mistake. We need to put all candidates through a test that can simulate the effects of the brutal pressure on the divers. Build a new opera house. Yeah, so you want to simulate a horrible, loud noise. Build an opera house. Sounds fair. Oh, we should have put... I wonder if the Opera House would have fitted in there. I bet it would.
His Royal Majesty has instructed me to present you with this...
We've got loads of time. We'll take the treasury subsidy. That'll be fine. Opera House. Where's the Opera House? That's in Luxury Entertainment, I think. Yeah, here we go. Opera House. Oh, you know we can squeeze this in? Like, around the back of here. Yeah, we might do that. Create a bit of a... I might put it there, and like I might put some parks in there to kind of pretty it up. Actually, if I spin it around that way, will it fit? Yeah, I might put some parks in around it. Yeah, that's where it's going. Cool. We want to get this going as quick as possible, so let's make that high priority. Although, I don't think there's anything else to build. We've got loads of construction workers. I am seriously thinking about putting a second dock in. Because we're producing quite a lot of stuff. We've already got like 12,000 and we've got 7,000. Oh, we've got tons of cash coming in, guys. This is awesome. Is there anything else we can build? Let's look at the... that's raw resources. I could put mines and stuff in, but... Oh, you know what? I'm going to put a wharf in. We're going to get some fish going, I think. Because that's an extra food source. Where shall I put the wharf? Do I want all my docks in one place? Yeah, I probably do. Let's put this up here if we can. Yeah. I like that idea. So we've got a wharf going. So that's another food source.
I sat with three other members of the research team. Suddenly, it dawned on us.
Foreman. Yes, we know that jug. Right. You know what? I'm going to put a cattle ranch in somewhere. Like, if I can fit one in, like anywhere. I'm thinking like maybe over here somewhere. Spin you round. And how about putting you in like there? Nah. It's all very yellow though. That's the only problem. Would be nice to put it somewhere greener. What else can go in here? What about llamas? Because we could do the whole wool thing. That's not till the next era though. So, yeah, not going to worry about it. Pigs? No? Yeah, you could put goats in, but I'm not going to worry about
so
goats.
Angry with those divers. They said they are too underpaid.
Bribe five fishermen. If we didn't need anything, I would propose you motivate them with a gunshot to their heads. That's the way I would prefer to go, to be honest. But I'm afraid that wouldn't work. Give them what they want so we can get our hands on that beautiful pub. Bribe five fishermen. Okay, so... what's going to be the easiest way to do that? And I'm thinking, if we go to... people, and we go down here to... employed. We go to the employed fishermen. Ha, here we go. So...
Good day.
We can just... Oh, now, we want to...
Good day.
We want to bribe the cheapest ones, so we'll bribe you 1,000.
Good day.
Oh, bribe you 1,000.
Hmm?
That's 5.
At your service.
That's 1,000. So that's 3.
Good day. Good day.
How can I be of help?
Oh, 4. And 5. That'll do it. That'll do very nicely. Right, thank you for that. Go away. 2. Come on, I bribed 5. Seriously? Oh, come on, I bribed 5 fishermen. Oh, come on. That's a bit mean. Let's do that again then. So what the hell do I employed? We can do these one at a time now, I think. So, oh, you only cost 500. We'll bribe you. And then let's... Maybe you have to do them like... Okay, so it's registered that one. It's kind of annoying that it didn't register the other 3 that I did. Let's try that again. So, fisherman... I guess it's a warning for
Ay,
you guys.
Caramba.
Bribe... did I banish instead of bribe? Oh, God.
Greetings.
That was a boneheaded thing if I did. I arrested this gun, didn't I? Oh. All right, bribe. Whatever. Oh, dear. You guys will be laughing your asses off about that. Right, bribe. That's another 2. That should be enough now. There we go. All right. Oh, dear. A bonehead moment. They're going to happen every now and then. Right, let's do this.
Brilliance, His Royal Majesty.
Have a new lumber mill. Okay, well, we'll do that.
I found this book in your office, Governor.
Build a pineapple plantation. Yeah, we can do that.
The revolution dictates that all people are...
Hire a manager. Yeah, we can do that. So...
We found out how to use...
Cool, we've got military fort. So, we want to hire...
Bell tests weren't sufficient, old fellow. Even Penultimo can dive that deep if he holds his breath.
Okay, European scientists are already experimenting with the bathyscape, a more sophisticated and complex method to reach the deepest deeps. A friend of mine runs Tykea, a company obsessed with parts. They could disassemble a bathyscape and ship it to us in the form of 1,000 tiny bits. The rest is DIY. Import. 9,999 resources. Find the Black Pearl. Alrighty. Okay. Let's. You know what? I'm going to slow that down a little bit. So, since we're importing stuff, I'm going to put in another dock, I think. Dock. Now, the thing is, do I put it in the same place or do I put it somewhere else? I'm thinking maybe we have it, like, over here. Yeah. Yeah, because then we, like, from stuff that we do over here, it'll be quicker to get it to the docks. So we're doing that. We need to import some stuff. So the question is, what the hell are we going to import? Is there anything that we could import that would be, like, a good thing? Or something that we could maybe export? And a good price. What you need to look at is the difference between the import and the export price. So we can get this at 1,200, but we can only sell it at 1,000. Corn. Oh, that's got to be the best bet, I think. Is there anything cheaper than that? We can get wool. No. Oh, that's the one. Wool. No, that's definitely not. Well, I think we're going to go for corn then. Yep. So we'll add a ship to that. Okay, so we're importing corn. That's the declare independence, isn't it? Yeah, well, we're not doing that. This will set to a high priority because we want that dock built pretty darn quickly. What else? I could go into here and like, oh, smuggler's dock we've got. Illegally imports extra goods from started import trade routes. Ew! And provides additional trades or it's with smugglers. Ooh, we should get some of those put in. How are we doing for cash? Loads of cash. Our approval rating's coming up. You know, I'd really love to put... You know what? I'm going to put in a cattle ranch just to get the extra food source. Because it'll make people happier. And even though things are, you know, the terrain is not good. Although, there's a little bit over here we could, like, potentially squeeze one in here. It's not absolutely horrible for cows. Let's spin that round this way then, and let's put a road in. Let's put the building in there, and we'll do a road thing really. Let's run it like across. Oh yeah, across there, and then we'll hook it up to there. There we go. Alrighty, so that's another food source, so that'll make people a bit happier, which is a good thing. Right, how are we doing with our imports? Well, we need to crank this up, don't we? We haven't put a manager in the Catholic mission. That's what I was going to do. Manager. What do we want? Kind doesn't matter too much. Let's put in a... What am I going to put in? Might as well 60 more durable. Yeah. Don't care. Increases housing quality. Yeah. Yeah, all right. Yeah, we'll do that. Okay, so
thanks for your efforts. The revolutionary...
Yeah, we'll take the some more educated revolutionary types. What else? Plantation. We can put in a pineapple plantation. We can do that one. So, remember to change it to pineapple. Skye, you bonehead. And then, like, where are we going to put it? I guess over here. And this is where... This is, you know, what I was saying about using this little trick. See, if I tried to put this building there, it wouldn't let me. See, it's red. But if I turn it round so that the building part comes out of the fog of war, it'll allow me to put the bit there, like there, it'll allow me to put it in, even though half of it is in the fog of war. So, there you go. Little tip. But I think what we're going to do... I don't want to eat into the lumber camp, do I? Can I squeeze in this way round? Oh, see there. It's eating into the lumber camp, but those lumber camps are probably going to get... Oh. This area over here is not too bad. Well, I wanted to save that area, didn't I? Yeah. So that's not a good plan either. Good grief. I wish I could squeeze this in a bit better. You know, I might. Yeah. I could squeeze it in like there, which is not the worst in the world. It's not good, though. Is it anywhere better? I could put it... Maybe squeeze it in over here. Can I? Like, I can't even. Wow! Oh, okay, well, that's sucking donkeys at the moment. Oh, come on! Yeah, you'll go there. Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to put
President,
it in. Like, what the hell?
After suffering a thousand...
Okay, newspaper's unlocked. Thank you for that, Penultimo. Right, let's put a road down there. And a road... I want this to be all kind of... All over the place. The roads. I don't want it to be all gridded out and stuff. I want it to be nice and organic. Could probably fit a ranch or something in here. Might end up putting a road in or something. Well, we've got the mine over there. So I suppose we go up the road to the mine. Maybe put a ranch or something in somewhere. Oh, we've got a ship coming in. We got anything to export? Yeah, we have. That's another 6,000. We've got loads of cash. We're certainly not short the cash. Thank you. We'll take 3 more educated citizens. We've already exported 3,000. Lumber mill we want. Now, where's the lumber mill? That's in industry. Lumber mill. And we're going to put our industry down here. So I'm probably going to put it, like, there, to be honest. Yeah. Like right next to the, okay, let's do that. Let's prioritize that. We could quick build it. I mean, we could afford to, but I'm not going to. It'll be cool. We're producing loads and loads of logs. But with our cotton plantations, when we get into the next era, we're going to be able to do the whole textiles thing, and that's going to get us off to the next era with a bang. 25 citizens arrived. How are we doing? Doing great at the moment. I mean, we could actually afford to, like, think about building some houses for people. But we don't want to go crazy.
Majesty has instructed me to present you with this letter of commendation for your achievements in the name of the...
We'll take the cash. I should probably start thinking about putting forts and things in. Yeah, okay, whatever. Because we haven't got any military at the moment. And we're going to have to declare independence. And mind you, we've got enough cash that we can buy them off.
You're shaking.
Oh, no.
You're shaking.
We've got an earthquake. Oh, my God. So, actually, somebody asked me to play with disasters turned on. Oh, good grief.
I am now going to rethink
Look at this.
And the choices I have made.
Okay, but we got 13,000.
Evaluate the damage.
From the disaster relief. You know what? Let me slow this down. And let's rebuild all, 11,000. And repair. Cool. Okay, and there's one of these, isn't there? Yeah, there is there. Nope, not that one. Why? Oh, we're short of workers, because some people died, I guess. Let's invite some foreign workers. Get those workers back. So which one of these was damaged, then? I'm sure one of the... Oh, was it the fishing wharf that was damaged? No, everything seems okay. Alrighty. I need to up the budget on the wharf. I need to up the budget on the pineapple plantation that I put in there. I can't remember where. Let's crank the budget up on that. We'll put in the upgrade because it's... Yeah. See, this increases the effectiveness of other pineapple plantations.
They say a man's home is his castle, old chap.
Build cheap homes.
The river.
Yeah, we'll take the... Okay, five new country houses we need to build. Well, there you go, so... That's kind of perfect timing. Residential. So we want 5 country houses. Where should we put them? I guess we should put them next to the church to get the benefits of that. So let's put them... should we put a row in, like along here? Yeah, what the hell? 1, 2, leave a gap. 3, 4, and then let's put the other one, like, there, just to be different. There we go. Again, you put in a row, like one just continuous row, and it looks like... Neh. What's this? No, this is the Catholic mission. Do I want to quick build it? Yeah, not really. It'll get built soon enough. Okay, so this is going to probably bring... Is this an import one or... No, it's not an import one. Okay, well, let's speed this up then. I think I had a kitten ball of string moment because I'm sure there was something I was going to do that I haven't done. We can bump the budget up on that now. Actually, I'm going to bump it up to just well off rather than rich.
The revolutionary movement is...
Excellent. We've got more revolutionaries. How are we doing people-wise? We should be doing, like, pretty darn good at the moment. Yeah, we've got four open jobs.
We, the leaders of the Tropican nation, in our desire...
Oh! Word. Cool, so... It's just a... Oh, we've got another quest.
The more I read the works of Conrad
I think we've done that, haven't we?
The least to your efforts.
Yes, we have.
Revolutionary...
We'll take more educated citizens. Another quest.
We need
hire a new manager in any building. Let's hire a manager in the lumber mill. That would be a good place to hire someone. And we want a foreman. Increase the effectiveness.
Yep. His Majesty watched the bonfire burn with joyful glee.
Yeah, whatever.
He enjoyed the event so much that he decided to hold an even bigger bonfire.
At what price will you sell your planks? Do we need the extra? We kind of don't. Oh, you know what? Let's have the increased revolutionary support. Yeah, we'll do that. Now, what was I doing? Yeah. This is the thing with this game. It distracts you. We need... Autosave! Thanks for that, mate. Right, let's crank the budget up on that. Let's hire that manager that I wanted. I want a foreman. Let's do it quick before
thanks
it
to your
distracts me again. See?
Revolutionary woman
is- yeah, we'll take more revolutionaries. Things are going well. We're up to 44% support already. We've got ships coming in. We've got cash coming in. We're up to 6,000 parts imported. This is all very cool. 15 more people arrived. We've got 40,000. Seriously, we're flying, guys. I can afford to do pretty much anything I want at this point. You know what? Let's put in, because you do get like pirate attacks and stuff. So let's put in some military, shall we? Let's put in... I want to protect this area down here for sure. Let's put in... I'm actually going to pay attention to where, like, entrances and things are. I don't think it matters with these. No. So let's put in a couple of guard towers there. And I want to put them... I suggest putting them in at least in pairs. I'm going to put another couple on that side of the building as well. So that's that very well protected. Is there anything else that I want to protect? My ass! So I'm going to put a couple of guard towers in front of the palace. Let's pop those in there. And I could have done loads more, but we got loads of cash. I could put a fort in as well, couldn't I? Ooh, it's an interesting idea. Don't know where we'd fit one in, though. We're running out of space. I suppose I could have sent the palace guard out to explore, but... bothered. Not really. How are we doing? Everything is flying along. Everything's getting built, which is very seriously cool. Is there anything I need to... Oh, you know what? We can up the budgets on the docks as well. I hadn't done those. That's going fine. I can up the budget on the ranch. I can do an upgrade on this as well. Yep, to do that. Anything else that I've missed? Oh, this is another import. No, it's not. I thought that was... or is it? We're up to 9,000. We're exporting planks. Oh, it's going to be a race to see that if we can export the planks before we finish this one. So I don't think that's going to happen. We haven't used the smuggler's docks yet. What's this quest?
Support for the revolution is increasing.
Increased job happiness above 45.
Thanks to your efforts, the revolutionary
already at 56. Yep, more revolutionaries. That's going to increase our support. We're going to be independent soon, guys. How cool is that going to be? You know, I've got to say, I'd forgotten how much... I might go back and play the original campaign again, because it is kind of fun. And I did it so rubbish the first time. Oh, another quest. Take that. Export 3,000 pineapples. Yeah, we can do that. That's not a problem, I don't think. Should probably whack another pineapple plant in somewhere, but... Again, like where? Don't have any room anywhere. So we got the we're doing great. I think we're just waiting for this last import to arrive, and then we're going to be pretty much done. Cash is great. Cash is pretty blooming awesome. We're bringing in loads of cash. Yeah, I mean we're in such good shape. Such good shape. I could put in more of these oyster fishery things, couldn't I? Probably. Should we put in some more oyster farms? Yeah, let's put in some more oyster farms. Because you can, I think you can put them like basically anywhere you like. So I think you can just put them like all over the place. What about down here? There's one there we can put in. What about over here? Yeah, what the hell? Let's have those all over the place. Why not? If those look like they're working, then we can put like them in like all around the island, because there's bound to be loads more. So that's great. That's a really good way to expand your economy. Like that. I like this whole Waterborne thing. For those of you who are following SimCity, this kind of ties in nicely with what I'm doing with SimCity. Whoa, we got it.
Wow.
Penultimo. So Pearl, such black, much amazed. Wow. Excuse my rambling, I just lost my mind. Just by looking at the Black Pearl, I bet we, I mean you, will be extremely rich once this miracle is sold. Now we have to find a customer who is rich enough to pay top dollar for it. Hey! And we've completed the first mission. Well, there it is. That's it. We're done. We'll come back for the next mission, guys. How deep is the ocean? And we'll be off to Ojos del Diablo. Is that Eyes of the Devil? I think. Oh, see you for the next one, guys. Peace out.